Okay, so welcome back. In this tutorial, we are going to look at how to insert page borders and page coloration to your WPS Office Suite. Okay, to start with, all you need is just to be on that particular document that you want to insert the page borders on. You can just come all the way to page layout. Okay, you can see page borders from here. You can select on page borders and you can see the different kind of defaults, the different kind of settings. This is page border and you can see the settings. You have none right now, it's set at none, and you can set a box. You want a simple box around your text. You can see the definition of the kind of style that you may have. You have multiple styles that you can pick from if you are interested, but let's say for this tutorial at this moment we'll go with the plain line, and then you can change the coloration if you want. Can go with something like this or something like this, and then the width of the line, you can play around with it, the thickness of the line, you can play around with it, and the kind of art that particular line is going to carry, you can play around with it as well. And then what kind of border do you have, the preview, you can preview on each angle. Right now everything is selected, the four angles are selected and everything is going to be covered. So this should be applied to the whole document or to a particular section or to the first page only or to all page except this. Okay, you can define which page should contain, but at this moment I want to include everything to the whole document. And then once you are set with this, you are certain, you can just go ahead and say okay to this, and you can see you've inserted a border to your text or to your document. You can see the border is very clear and very clean. If you don't want to customize it one more time or you want to customize it again with different features, you can still come back to the page layout and come back to borders. Okay, so you can just go ahead, select any, assuming we go with something like this. You can see the preview from here and you can just go ahead and say okay, and you can see it has changed everything to that particular line. So you can play around with it depending on your choice, depending on your kind of test. What kind of test do you have and what kind of line do you have? If you have a given definition, maybe you want something like this, something like this, and you want it to just have this on the sidebar or on the top and bottom. You can see this is top, this is bottom. You can remove on the sides just like so, and once you say okay to this, it's going to be only the top and the bottom that is going to carry this border. Okay, so the border is very interesting. It makes your work look very, very professional and nice. You can go ahead and play around with it depending on what kind of document you are trying to produce, and you have more options also from here. And you can play around with the top and bottom width, okay, from text, this much distance from the text and this much distance from the bottom. If you don't want it to be perfectly aligned to the text, just like we have in the document, you can play around with the left, right, top and bottom, and then the text from text or from margin, depending how you want to separate the document. So you can go ahead and play around with all these and see which of the features you find interesting, and you can play around with it. You can come to the shading in case if you want to change the fill color, you can change the fill color as well within that particular border. So for example, over here, assuming we select this and we want everything to be complete border, and we want the shade to take in something like this, you can see the preview. Okay, so you can see the definition, everything is taken. And once you say okay, everything becomes this coloration. So if you want to remove the border, okay, at any given point you want to remove border, you can just come over here, come to the border, you can come to none, and once you click on okay, everything now goes back without the border. Okay, so you can see how powerful this feature is. Very easy to just play around with to create borders to make your work appear professional and nice. The next thing is we'll try to look at the page coloration. So assuming we have some border, let's have some very basic border. Assuming we have this border, and I kind of like this this one, okay, and maybe coloration, we can select something like this, and then we say okay to this. Assuming I have this border and I want to put in some coloration to the page, then come all the way to the same page layout and come back to page coloration. You can see the multiple colors that you can put on the page. For example, you could go with this gradient. I always like to have gradient. You can see now everything changes, the coloration now changes, but this red color is not professional. We can have something like this, and you can see the document is changing completely. If you don't want this, you can go ahead and come to more colors, or You can come to more colors and you can define the kind of color that you want by just navigating around. Once you select a given color, you say okay and everything turns to that color. Okay, so you can see, I think this is cool because it aligns with the text. And then you can come also if you want more colors, or you have a specific place that you want, maybe you want the coloration to be of this, from this color, from this yellow color, you can come to the same more color. You can come to eyedropper, and eyedropper is a feature that you can use to navigate to wherever you want to pick the color from. Assuming I want this yellow, I can come over here. You can see with the eyedropper, once I click, everything now becomes that color. Okay, it now becomes this yellow color, and see within my document. Okay, or if you want, you can come to picture background. If you have a picture that you want to put, you can easily select the picture and you can use that as your background. Okay, so just go ahead, select any picture, and you can come bring it in, and you can see the preview once you said okay, and it's going to set this as a background for you. You can see, very nice. Okay, so this is picture background. If you don't want the picture, you can maybe set other backgrounds, maybe gradient background, texture background, or pattern background. Let's say gradient, or let's say texture. You can select the texture from any texture. Assuming you can select this, or you can go with something like this, and once you say okay to this, everything now becomes this background. So you can see, you can play around with the background color and even add different kind of texture to it, or different kind of gradient to it, so it looks kind of fantastic and nice. You can come all the way and put in the texture. You can change it to something like this, and once you say okay, the whole write up now changes. So you can see the power of the coloration in the page. Okay, and at any given point also, if you want to remove the page color, you can just come to no color, and everything now is removed, and it's now back to plain or white background like we have. So I think that does it for adding page borders and page color to your document in WPS Office Suite. In our next class, we're going to look at how to add multiple columns within a particular document. So this is very useful when you are writing a paper. Sometimes in some papers or in some journals, the requirement is that you have two columns for the document before you submit. So we're going to look at how to do that with WPS Office Suite in the next class. So until then, thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next class. Bye.